Hi everyone, and welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. My name is Nate Carpenter, and today we're going to be looking at a user area in Scriptcase. So that's this area up here on the left of the menu. And you see here it shows the username and the user email, as well as links to change the password and to log out. So if I click change password, that takes me to the change password application there, and then logging out would log me out of the application. So we're going to be looking at how to build this today. So let's go to Scriptcase here. And we have our menu application. This is the menu for our recruitment sample system. And I'm going to show you how headers work. So that area over there on the left is in the headers section of the menu. And headers in Scriptcase have a template as well as footers. And if I click on this dropdown, these are all the templates that headers can fit into. And then once we set the template, those templates have variables in them, like this here, and we can set values to those variables, like so. So let's create our own template for this menu. So we're going to go to Layout, HTML Templates, and these are all the templates. So I have a lot of templates in my system here. I'm going to create a new one. So I click New Template. I'm going to name it. And then for the type, we're going to choose Header. So we could have a footer or a user HTML or grid. We're going to choose Header, and then for the scope, we're going to choose project, so it'll be limited to the project. And now we just have a blank area to put some code. So let me put that in here. It's a lot of code, but let me explain it, and a lot of it you can copy. So we start out with a whole bunch of CSS here. So this is setting some padding, box sizing, more padding, different background colors, like so. Border styles, widths, you know, more styles for that. We have all these different areas here in the menu user area here. So just, you know, looking through some of these you can customize if you want to make them look a little bit different. And then we have some JavaScript here. So we have a function. We have this menu area. We'll see that in HTML. It's a function. When you hover over it, it will open it up there, like so. So that's one of our classes up here. So that's the JavaScript. And that sets it to display block right there with that open class. Now we've got the actual body of the document here. So we've got some different divs and containers. You might also notice here, these curly braces here. Those are the variables that you saw back in the menu application that we can set equal to whatever we want. So wherever we put this template, wherever we use it, we can assign values to these different variables. So first we've got the logo here, and that's an href. That's a link that opens up when you click it. Then you've got the menu here, and it's got an image there. That's our avatar image. Then the username. So that's the outside of it before you hover into it. And then down here, we've got another class info with another avatar right there. This is to the left. And then on the right, we've got the username and the user email. Then below all that, we've got the links. So we've got the link label right there and then the URL right there. So we can assign those values in the menu. So let's hit save on this and let's use this template in our menu. So I'm going to go to visual settings here, where we were before, and choose our template here. So click the drop down, and we need the user template here. So give me a second to find that. There it is right there. And let's hit save on that. Let's go to header footer now. So now we have the template set. We need to tell it to display the header right there. So we can hit save on that. And now we need to assign some values to all those different variables. Let's leave the first one blank for now. Let's set the image now. So this is going to be an avatar. And here we are, we're in project and general images. And there is our avatar image right there. Let's click add selected for that. And that'll put our avatar up there like so. Now let's run this and see what it looks like. Okay, so now we have our avatar up there on the left. So now let's put the rest in there. So first, we need to do the item label. So this is the first link that we can click on. If we look, it's right there. So that's what we're setting, these two plus the URLs. So let's choose value for the type. And it's going to be change password, since that's the first one. And then the second one is going to be logout. So that's the text for the link. So now let's assign values. Let's assign the links. So URL 1, we'll go with label 1, like so. And that's our application that we have to change the password. And then URL2 will go to the login application like so, which will automatically log the user out when it's loaded. So now we have our two links and our avatar image. Let's hit save. And that's all set up. Let's run it. So now we should have an avatar and two links like so. We can click one of those. We're not logged in right now, so it's displaying a security error. But now let's go back and set the rest of these up. So now we need to set up the logo over here. So let's click image again. And we have a logo right here in that same folder. This could be any logo you wanted, so that'll display the logo. Now we need the URL for when that logo is clicked. So let's choose value, and this is just going to go to the Scriptcase homepage like that. You can make it go wherever you want. And let's run this and see if that logo works. So there's our logo. There's our user area, and then our logo here. So we click that, and it takes us to the Scriptcase homepage just like we'd expect. So now let's set the other value, so the username. We're going to set some hard-coded values for now, but I'll show you how to programmatically set those in a minute. So I put in the email there, and now I'm going to put in the username. We'll programmatically set these in a minute, but let's just run this so we can see what it looks like. Okay, so it's loaded, and now it has my username and my email, as well as the change password and log out options there. So if I click log out, and it logs me out, and now I'm going to log back in here. Let me get rid of that. Okay, now I'm logged out. Let's click change password. And there is our change password application. All right, so now we need to set these username and user email values programmatically using the values from the database. So to do that, we need to go to our login application where those values are saved as session variables. So we're going to go to events here and the onValidate event. So this is when the user clicks login. It checks whether the username and password that they entered is valid. And if it is, so there's no errors here, it'll get those values out from what they entered there. So that's set up here. And then it'll set a global variable with those values. And it gets the email right here from a different table and sets the email value right there. So user email and user login are the two values that we want for this. So let's go here. We need to use the square brackets to access those session variables inside a script case. So user email and now the user login here, like so. So if we run this, we should see these values now. So we run it, and we're not logged in, but it does have our email and username, admin, and samples@scriptcase.net. So those are the values it got out of the database. Now we need to make it so when we click this change password, it doesn't open it up in another window like this. We want it to load within the menu. So to do that, we need to set the target of that application. So that's this target right here. So that's where that value is set. So let's go back to our menu here. And let's go ahead and log in here. So we got to log out and make sure we're fully logged in. Click login. And let's look at where these buttons go on the menu. So if we view the source for one of those, we see the item target is menu iframe. That's that iframe right there below the menu. So here, we just need to type in menu iframe and set it as the target. So this is just kind of how you would do it in HTML. This is just setting the target for an A tag, like so. And now it should open it up within the menu itself. Let's run this. Let me log out and log back in so we can fully authenticate. Type in the password here and click login. And now let's click the change password button. So go here, change password, and it loads within the menu itself without going to another window and taking over the screen. So that's basically everything there is to setting up a user area inside of Scriptcase on a menu so that you can display whatever info you want there and it'll work for you. So I hope this was helpful for you, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.